They've triggered the alarms. Please, help us.
It's too late for that now.
We're not giving up now. Reroute all power to the thrusters.
But the plasma core!
Just do it!
If you've been keeping up with video generators lately, you will know that Google VEO3 is taking all the attentions right now, and it is for a good reason. If you've seen super realistic videos just like the ones you just watched right now, Google VEO3 is the tool behind them. For the past week, I've taken ample time to delve deeper into how it works, so in this video, I'm going to take you along with me so that you will see for yourself what it is good at, what it struggles with, and how it could be better. So at the end of the video, you can decide for yourself if it is worth the $250 per month that it costs. I work a lot with animation, so I'm super excited to put it to the test. So does VEO3 live up to the hype? Let's find out together. One thing that really impressed me about this VEO3 is how it creates both visuals and audios together. You give it a simple prompt, it generates both the video, the voiceover, the sound effects, and at times even the background music, all at one go. It's really a big deal for anyone who wants to make videos quickly and very easily. Getting started with it is super simple. You can either use it through Google Flow or use it through Gemini app. I will talk more about how to get started later, but right now, let's dive into what it can actually do. I asked it to create a sci-fi scene where an alien ambassador talks to a human captain in a high-tech meeting room. In just 3 to 5 minutes, it generated the video. Let's take a look at it.
Your species has proven itself unpredictable, Captain, but we're willing to extend a peace treaty.
And what's the price for peace?
Wow. Everything came out super realistic, except for the subtitles that are gibberish. In fact, I didn't even ask it to produce subtitles for me. Well, overall, I was really impressed. If you didn't look very close, you wouldn't even notice that it's generated with AI. It's that powerful. I even took that same video and removed the audio and put it in Runway ML to see if it can generate that same quality of dialogue for me. But Runway Emma couldn't do that. It couldn't handle it at all because there are two faces close to each other. That is something I've not seen any tool that can handle that well. Next, let's try with Epic Scene and see how it handles that. So I gave it this prompt about a ship battling a storm at sea.
Hold fast!
We're gonna make it through, right?
We have no choice!
This is incredible. In fact, this is one of the best videos I've generated with VEO3. It is super realistic. So I went ahead and gave it this second prompt about a dragon in a cave with a lone adventurer.
This ends tonight, beast.
This one is almost perfect, except that a man came out looking at the camera instead of looking at the dragon. But still, it is super impressive. Next, let's see how well it handles camera movement. So I'll go ahead and give it this prompt about a high-tech bank in the future.
We're running out of time. Shut down the systems before they breach the core.
This is really great. It came out with different camera movements and even different scenes. Overall, it came out looking pretty good, except for a few flaws. Next, let's try with different kind of video. Let's start with 3D animations and see how well it handles that. So I gave it this prompt about a princess and her pet dragon. This came out looking pretty solid, like something from Disney movie, except that it didn't have any audio, not at all, no speaking. I even had to check my settings to be sure that I didn't mistakenly turn off the audio, but the setting seems very okay. The volume was turned on, so I decided to give it a different prompt with the same girl and dragon. Maybe there was an issue that I didn't take note of earlier. Let's see what happens. Still the same issue, no audio. What could be the problem? Could it be an issue with 3D? Just to be sure that there isn't something wrong with my VEO3, as a whole, I decided to give it a different prompt for a realistic video.
We've fought too hard to turn back now. This land is ours and we'll defend it to the last breath.
And that seems to work. It has audio. So could the problem be with the 3D animation? Maybe, The issue is because there is Disney in the prompt. Maybe as Disney is a brand, it decided to skip audio. So I decided to remove Disney from the prompt and gave it the same prompt. Let's see. Still no audio. I wondered, could it be because dragon isn't a real animal? Is that the reason why it's skipping the audio? So I decided to give it entirely different prompt of a boy and a dog. At least the boy and the dog are real. Let's see what happens. That didn't solve the problem. Still no audio. That didn't seem to work. So at this point, I'm confused. Well, let's continue with a different style of video. Let's try with anime and see how well it handles that too. Let's see the video. As you can see, it came out looking pretty okay, except that it had the same audio issue. Well, at this point, I really think we need to investigate further and see why our animations, anime and 3D animations, are not talking. So I decided to go on Gemini chat and ask what the issue really is. Let's see the response I got from Gemini. I was hoping that Gemini would give me a fix or tell me what I was doing wrong, but instead it gave me a straightforward answer. It said that users of VEO3 have been reporting frustration and inconsistent issues, especially with the audio of 3D animations and anime videos. It explained that the main reason for the silent videos is that the audio generation feature of VEO3 is still in the experimental stage. As a result, users have seen a lot of inconsistencies. Some videos come out with perfect sound, while others with similar prompts stay completely silent. I can clearly see that the fault is not mine, but rather from VEO3 being at its experimental stage. So now that I've put Google VEO3 to the test, here are my three conclusions. First, the biggest issue I noticed with VEO3 is how unreliable it is. Actually, the audio is its major selling point, but at times, the sounds and the camera movement come out pretty amazing. Other times, you give it the same prompt and they come out with no audio or no camera movements, especially with 3D animations and anime. So for every good result, you might have to try 5 times just to get one usable video. Let me show you 2 examples of really bad videos he gave me.
We need to secure that artifact now.
Captain, the inertial dampeners are failing.
As you can see, the first one was complete garbage, but the second one came out a little bit better, but then you'll find out that the characters were standing for too long, which wasn't good at all. Another problem with the speech is that VEO3 tend to put subtitles in your video, even when you didn't ask it for subtitles, and most times the subtitles are gibberish, nonsense, just like the one I showed you in the earlier video. Also, the lip sync can at times be pretty bad, especially when the characters are not humans. For example, I tried making a panda talk inspired by Kung Fu Panda.
Do it. The truth is, everything you need is already in.
This is completely off. No lip syncing at all. I adjusted a prompt and tried again. Let's see.
Sometimes the biggest obstacle is thinking you can't do it. The truth is, everything you need is already inside.
It came out a little better, but still not perfect. Let's try another prompt, this time with an alien.
Your species is on the brink of destroying itself. We've been watching for centuries.
The result is terrible. So this is how VEO3 struggles with speech, lip sync, and audio. The second problem with VEO3 is that it is very expensive. You have to pay $250 every single month just to use it. And even at that, you don't get unlimited generations. Each video costs almost $2. And looking at how inconsistent it is like burning your money just to get one good video. Lastly, and probably the biggest drawback with VEO3 is that it doesn't support image to video generations yet. And what that means is that you can't generate consistent characters and voices, and for serious projects, because you need your characters to stay consistent in order to create professional videos. Though I think that in the next few months, they are going to add this feature, looking at how fast the technology is moving. But at the meantime, it is a real problem. So, at this point, I can't recommend VO3 for most users. You probably will get better values with other tools like Clean AI, Hello, Luma Labs, PixFast, and others. They cost way cheaper and they give you complete control on how you can create consistent characters. You probably will get more results that way. Anyway, it's amazing to see how far AI has come. VO3 has shown us that AI is advancing so quickly, and in the near future, I believe that AI will do more greater things for content creators. If you find this video helpful, do me a favor by liking the video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on important tips. And I would love to see your comments in the comment section. Let me know what you think about VO3. Thank you for watching.